announce NASA's new space program, which will send a family of rats.
Yes, Veronica. It's true. Your ex-husband is still alive and living in Cairo.
Four and slide, 2, 3, 4, and reach, 2, 3, 4, and slide, 2.
The 7-year-old was peddling his toy in front of a drugstore to get money to eat.
He told me that he was trying to sell a stuffed animal to get money for food because he hadn't eaten in several days.
Officer Dunham took the child to Subway to get something to eat, then brought him back to the Franklin Police Department.
I said a little prayer and ate dinner together.
That is so nice of him.
And that's exactly what law enforcement.
There's this unarmed guy, right?
I shot him, bro.
And then he was unarmed too. And guess what I blamed it on? Guess what I blamed it on? Himself! Oh, 10-4, we got a jaywalker. Should we get him?
We'll give him a pass.
Hey, hold on, hold on,
you
see that person over there?
What? I see him!
Hey,
get out of the car, bro!
Get out of the car!
Oh!
Hi, officers, what's the problem?
Get down on the ground! Put your hands behind your back! Put your hands behind your back!
Welcome to iHeart Police News. Recently today, coming from the police department, a suspected armed and dangerous woman with a possibility that she had the intent to cause harm to others with possibly a crime record, and with the certainty of intent to resist arrest and to cause violence to police officers, was shown doing illegal activities in the neighborhood in which she most likely did not reside in, possibly robbing houses and carjacking in the area. Is now detained. Here's a statement given by the police captain, also at the scene.
Today at approximately 13 o'clock. Yes, 13 o'clock at nighttime. Noon. Okay, at noon. There was this lady, and she looked very suspicious at the time. She didn't follow our instructions at all. So this is what clearly went down. We were driving in my police car, and she broke the law.
How? I think she had like a gun or something like that.
She had a gun or something.
What, RPG?
AK-47? Yeah, she had an AK-47 and she did not follow our directions at all. I told her to get down on the ground and put your hands behind your back, and she did not do that.
The accused person is now being detained for resisting arrest. Here's an interview I got of her before she got sent to prison.
So tell me, Danae, why did you resist arrest?
I didn't resist. I'll tell you exactly what happened.
I got down as they told me to, put my hands behind my back as they told me to, and they were beating me to death for no apparent reason.
Hold on, hold on. I'm gonna have to cut you off right there. That's not what the police department said.
They said you were trying to resist and trying to fight back. Is this true?
No, they were beating me down. I couldn't even breathe. There was a witness there. Can she not tell you what happened?
No, because she's now being detained for false information. The police department accused her of lying, trying to bring the police down.
Well, the police are racist, and I'll tell you that. That's a fact. Because they attacked me for no apparent reason, saying I resist arrest. When they came after me because of the color of my skin, not because of what I did, but because of the way I looked. And America needs to understand that Black Lives Matters too.
Okay, if you say so. Thank you for the interview. The following events that have occurred has started an uprising of riots and a trend of the hashtag Free Keisha and hashtag Free Monet on Twitter, saying that she is innocent and not guilty of crimes. But there are also people who are defending the police, who are suggesting that Keisha is in fact not innocent and charged with these horrible crimes. Thank you for tuning into iHeart Police News. We'll see you next time. Goodbye. Bad boys, what you want, what you gonna do when Sheriff John Brown come for you?
Tell me what you go, go, go. Oh, it's our safety, it's our... Wait, it's not loaded.
Come on, tell me how to do it.
Woo, shoot. We out.